have DTI here and a Claridus on the defense right now. So let's see how they will go. As you can see, right now we are playing for third place, and this is best of three. So if a Claridus team will be able to win this game, we will see one more round of this battle. Let's jump in. The teams are right now correctly placed. The defending team is a Claridus, the red team and the blue team attackers are DTI. DTI won the first round. A Claridus, they already played one game in defense. Let's see if they will actually be able to win this time. Maybe they have taken their lesson, they learned their lesson right from the previous defense. Let's see if they will again heavily focus the corner, or they will maybe split a little bit more, play more aggressively with some horses. Let's see about this one. Short reminder, DTI EU1 representation, Russian lineup, and a Claridus EU4 team, French lineup, clashing once more. Best of three, DTI won the first game. If you're interested, actually, for the Claridus, the favorite weapon of the captain is Maul. So, might be a good thing to watch for that. And let's see if the higher experience of the DTI team will win once more. Let's do a short analysis of the heroes. So, we can see that in the attacking team, DTI have full heavy armor, one longbow light armor only, and I guess that the split between hammers and so mauls, right, and the short sword is quite 50-50, while on the long sword there is one single sword, so long sword to heal and help. The DTI team is right now as well covering the wall. Let's remember that they lost again against Eden. Eden team won with us versus DTI with amazing push for the main gate with the cavalry. So DTI definitely learned their lesson. They said no more like that is happening. Nothing like that is going to happen. We are going to cover the gate for sure. So that's what they are doing very nicely. On the Claridus team, we can see one longbow, two muskets, and most heavy rest are heavy armor. Most of those short sword, similar matchup like previously. In the tournament, short reminder, all the rules, all the information about tournament, exclamation mark for help, exclamation mark help, you write it and the bot will message you via private message with all the information you need. Rules, prizes, betting, tournament, everything. But for the short, like short reminder, no golden era units, max 3 lives per player. If you die you 3 times you are out. And no artillery, so that's are the most important highlights. So we can see DTI trying to do something here with the push on the main gate. The Claridus team very nicely reacting to that. You can see that the push, the stance over here with the pikes and shields, it's clear you are not going through here. Sorry, DTI. And DTI agrees on that. So they move away to some other placement. Once again, we see the push and taking position above the middle siege tower. On this map, you have middle siege tower, right siege tower, and left siege tower. Three siege towers are here. DTI pushing in, taking the space, and let's see if they will do something with it. In the meantime, on the back end, the Claridus team is prepared for the push, and the push is coming. We can see few units here coming to this back tower, and the whole DTI team are right now running to pressure on the back plus. This is something we've seen pretty much in every game, pressuring the back plus. I guess most of the team when preparing and training, they have came with the similar conclusions. But so the like high level goal and the high level target is similar, but the executions on how it was done is totally different from each team, and this is something that is nice to see, the discrepancy. Look at that, DTI team, They faked the B attack. Look at that. Some of the people, like 3-4 people, are coming while they rotate back with most of their players, and they are attacking A point. This is something that was not, what was done a few times, but was never successful because the attacking team moves with much smaller units. Here we have quite a big presence. Let's see. We have Zikalian Milita throwing grenades from the back. This damage can be key to all the units. They throw fire grenades, which actually deal damage to a lot of units. And look at that. The DTI push was stopped. The first push was stopped. Grenadiers are working very nicely. Most of the units from the DTI team are dead. Let's see. Greenlock, can we see here the unit health bars? No, we cannot. So let's jump back. We can see that DTI team was pushed away. There is some fight that's happening behind the scenes. They still have some presence on the B. They have not given up this corner. This is crucial corner for any transitions between B and A. So definitely worth keeping up on DTI end. And still the push on the back end is happening. So here we have the stalwarts. Here we have some fight units. Archers once again from Ouma, nicely. Imperial archers shooting from the above. But once more, grenadiers from Zikarian Lita doing some serious damage, and let's see if they will able to defend this. Nice cavalry are clearing from behind. Most of the forces are dead here. And Clarides have successfully defended the back point. But they defended the back point on a big cost of A. They rotated too many players. Too many players was rotated to the B. They have overestimated the push from DTI. Overrotated, left not enough players on A, and the A side is captured by DTI. They have used, I don't know if you have noticed the map. Sorry, I should do a better job on the looking at the map, but DTI pushed from the both towers and captured the A very fast. And right now, the game is speeding up quite a lot. The DTI are on the pressure point. They can do whatever they want. The Clarides need to watch out to not be caught off guard. If they will overcommit once again to defending B point, they can be cut off from the main supply point, and DTI team can just block them from even making a defense on the main cap. But this is something that the Clarides are well aware of, and look at that. They just leave a minimal presence of some horses to just slow down DTI team from capturing B, and they are rotating and preparing their defense of the main cap. So this was something that was very nicely done from both sides. DTI nicely using the back point of extraction as taking the attention of the defenders, and then meeting fully on the A point, right? Taking it and progressing very fast, looking that enemy hasn't got any more defense. They progressed very fast. And then Eclarides reacted very maturely. Even though they are quite young players, they play the game for just 3-4 months. Their highest level player is around 750 level. So definitely the youngest team. They learn quickly, they see their mistakes, and they rotate that very fast. And we can also see that they have changed their tactic quite massively. If you remember from the first game they played, they have played very, very defensively, very, very deeply in the defense here in the corner, right? So they didn't put any pressure on the attackers. They let the attacking team to just go in and push them out. This trebuchet here, oh my god. Guys, trebuchets, there always must be something looking at the trebuchet. The Clarides team had a very nice defense setup. Unfortunately, half of this defense is gone due to the trebuchet. So DTI definitely putting pressure on two entry points. They are using right now more ranged units to harass the defenders. And let's see how it goes. The back point is not contested, so Eclarides have this under control. Seems like Eclarides also changed a little bit the placement on the last point. Last time they were split a little bit on the both sides of the point. Currently they are committed fully with everyone on the ground in the death corner. Let's see how this will end up to them. Maybe they have seen something that we have not seen. Let's look at the units right now. For the Eclarides, you can see a lot of Imperial Pikes, but DTI actually only 1-2 Imperial Pike units. This might be actually a very brilliant move. If you don't have Imperial Pikes, it's hard to move for this corner. So DTI team might have a very big problem breaking this defense down. Unless they came up with some flanking. And this is what they are doing right now. Look at that. The main force on the ground, they are creating pressure and just shooting some arrows. They are not pushing, they are not doing anything specific, taking their attention. While the flanking team is moving with archers to shoot in enemy back. And look at that! A Claridus team, just like one man army right now, fully committing to the push. They are playing the Endgegner strategy, what Endgegner did earlier, fully aggressively pushing. This is amazing. They notice that they are being flanked. 4 or 5 players are on the flank. This means 4 less players on the ground. Let's destroy the ground force fully. And that's what they did. So aggressively pushed. All the DTI force on the ground had to retreat or they died. So this was nicely done. No players died. Look at the top. You have 15 players alive on both teams. But the attack of DTA was put on hold. And right now DTI, they are doing counter-attack. They noticed that Aclarides, they have broken their ranks. This is the time to push right now. And that's what they did. They are using the Imperial Pikes. Remember, right? Like 20 seconds ago, Aclarides used all their Imperial Pikes to do the push. Right now, DTI counter pushed them with their Imperial Pikes. All Aclarides Imperial Pikes were on cooldown. They couldn't react on time. But there is still not gone. Aclarides team, 12 people alive, only 3 dead. So this is still quite nicely looking. The behind team, unfortunately, archers are retreating. They don't have any more ammo, so there is no support from the behind. If the Claridus are able to put enough pressure on the cap point, this is still not over. And the push is coming. They are coming with the shields. They are coming with their heavy armor. Trebuchets are flying in, obviously. This is the tactic that's always being used here, but they need to get into the point. Some of the short swords you can see, as well as long swords from Eclarides team, are on the cap. They are blocking the capture. So this is important. The capture point is not moving forward. And the attacking team is slowly bleeding out. Look at that. Imperial Pikes are pretty much only unit left. They are dying right now. Forte Brachios, they are also gonna die in a moment. And they have just archers left. Cavalry waiting nicely for the Imperial Pikes advance to finish. And then breaking through the ranks, attacking enemies from the flank. Seems like Eclarides have made it. They made the counter push. They defended it. They need to look at the trebuchets. Guys, trebuchets are flanking. You need to look at them. You here, mister, who are you? I don't know. Look at the trebuchets. Warn your team. You cannot lose your units. Because if you look at the top, the DTI have big unit advantage. And this is not over yet. The battle is still here. DTI is putting constant pressure, not allowing Aclarides to regroup, not allowing them to create their defense. Let's look quickly at the stats because it seems like the next push will be there shortly. So, for the statistics, we can see 400 units only left on Aclarides, 600 for DTI. They have the advantage here. When it comes to the heroes though, there are 19 people dead of Aclarides, 10 people only on the DTI. So, once more, advantage for the DTI. DTI have all the advantages except the time. 7 minutes left. Time is running slowly. Indeed, they have 60% of the cap captured, but will it be enough? I don't know. Aclarides, they are right now on their last units, as you can see. Hammer boys are here. Serfs are going to start coming in. Martellatori, all other units. This is not looking good. The unit fight is not looking great. Thankfully, the archers here are having full ammo. They are constantly putting pressure. We have arquebusers, Imperial arquebusers, in my opinion, best unit, arquebuser unit in the game. They are putting a lot of damage down. And we have Zekalian Milita once more. They can be key to destroy enemies with fire who are blobbing on the main point. We just need to see more tanky units and more heavy armor on the point. Guys, Aclarides, you need to block the point. You cannot allow any more point capture to be done. Remember, if you have anything, any unit or hero in the cap point, it's not going to be capped. But no one is there currently and it is being captured. We will see the finish to that. And this is something I was talking about. There was not enough people left, unfortunately, for Aclarides. Only 5 people alive who were able to jump in the camp point, but they were put under pressure. Most of the team of DTI was alive and they have done it. They have won 2-0. The Clarides are out of the tournament with 4th place taken. Congratulations. It's still quite nice considering this is one of the youngest team. DTI on the other hand, congratulations on winning your 3rd place, securing some prizes for you. Oh, intensive fight, very nice fight. Clarides, definitely this game was the highlight of the whole tournament appearance. They have reacted nicely, they did some mistakes, especially with the A push over rotating, right? When DTI pushed B, they over rotated to B and didn't leave enough people on A. But after that, they did everything quite nicely. So definitely the last game they can be proud of the most. The best appearance, in my opinion, out of them this tournament. Ooh, let me take a short breather. You can look at the stats. We will do a post-game analysis shortly. And I need to check when exactly is the last game starting. All right, so I will have probably information hopefully about the next game. I imagine this will start in 20 minutes because we have some things to talk through. We also plan to do the short talk with the DTI team leader if he will be available. And let's jump to the post game analysis. So DTI team winners. For the highlight players, definitely Sith Lord, 6 kills, but Montefool and Robert the Sable, 5 kills, nevertheless, not that far away. Assist, Heimdall, 19 assists. Holy moly, that's really a lot. And you can see Ouma, once more, very high score of unit kills. And remember, this is Longbow player. I watched at him a little bit. He is playing with the Imperial Archers, doing a lot of good work for his team. So definitely something to be proud of. He really did a lot of kills with these archers, key kills, and this allowed the team to push in few important places. The highest killing score, Robert the Sable, congratulations, 160. There are a few people over 100, so nice to watch. Don't forget, this is a tournament, kills don't matter if you win or lose, that's what matters on the end. So whole team, congratulations, you should be proud of yourselves. Did very, very, very well. On the Clarides team, as said, the last game definitely the best, and you can also see this reflected in the statistics. Two people over 100 kills, and you have most of the team over 70. So very well done. A lot of unit kills, quite nice hero kills presented as well. Unfortunately, they fought till the end. As a defenders, you need to sometimes, you know, give your life for the point. One second. Okay, so seems like the next battle will be at 11 minutes. One second, I need to check something. Seems like my browser has bugged, I need to restart it. Don't know what's happening, but forget it. Okay, Aritoshima PC have crashed, that's what's happening, that's why I couldn't see it. Yeah, guys, you need to remember that it's quite heavy on the PC, right? I'm really happy that I upgraded my PC recently, because we have me and the Aritoshima, right? The streamers, we have a lot of software open to with prizes, with rules, with everything. So it really takes a lot of pressure on the PC. Maybe even more than on some teams. I don't know. I would say that players won't agree, but yeah. Okay, let's go quickly to the post-battle analysis as we still have some time. So we are waiting for the Aritashima to restart his PC, restart all his software, and next game will be in like 20 minutes, 19 minutes or so. So let me add the counter as well. Okay. So post-game analysis. What happened from the TI perspective? They tried a few things and not all of them worked in the beginning. So they tried to play it quite standard, right? Going into the middle point, middle siege tower, pressuring A, but faking A and going to B. That's why they transitioned, but they have not gone to B immediately. They actually split their force in half and pressured A point a little bit. So you can see some deaths around 3 minute mark happening here because the fight were there. Highlight of this fight definitely for defending team Eclarides, Zikalian, Militia have been here. How it's played in this tournament, you know, all people in the same place, they the fire damage spread around every unit. This is key highlight, at least in my opinion, for this part of the game. Next on, the other half team of the DTI pushed in the behind. They tried, they actually moved the plus point, as you can see over here, right? So they go out, they try to flank from behind, they get on the point, but they bled out. And this is the first big mistake Eclarides team did. They overreacted to this push and moved too many people from A side here to defend it. They defended it successfully, yes, but this cost them A point because here you can see nothing is happening in terms of depth. Here a little bit, but other than that, not too much because no defense was there from Eclarides on A point, and DTI pretty much took the point for free. Later on, we can see the short fight with the cavalry on B, and DTI team had the full control of the map before the main cap. What they decided to do then is put a pressure on two entrances. So they used the gate as the main entrance for the ground force. Most of the players entered and grouped here, prepared for attack. And some of the team have moved over here. Over the ladders, we had the shields, we had some pikes, and we had two archer units, if I believe, both Namcans. What they wanted to do is attack from behind the death corner, which is a good strategy to do. The death corner is hard to clear out without artillery and without golden era units. Highlight here, definitely. Eclarides, you need to watch out for these trebuchets because some of them was crucial for DTI breaking through. The most crucial one, I would say, even of the fight was here, where half of the defense force from Eclarides was annihilated by the trebuchet. DTI break through and they moved their archer units behind here and covered them. So this was four players who have done that. In the meantime, this is a key highlight for Eclarides team. I think this is the best thing they did this whole tournament. They played it very amazingly in terms of aggression. They didn't wait. They seen what's happening. They seen that they are encircled over here and they have enemies coming from the front, from the back. They did not have the exact vision, how many here, how many there. So what they did, instead of staying in place and being just chopped down by the archers and bled out, they decided to make a stand. They made a push. Here we can see the results of that. In next 1 minute, a very big push from the Eclarides team. All of them have basically used all of their units in one single push. Very coordinated. Everything was done within like a few seconds. They moved off the corner and pushed. And this was nicely done. They killed quite a lot of DTI units. So definitely something to be proud of. Unfortunately, the DTI had this prepared. They actually waited for something like this. They wanted, I feel like, to bait them out a little bit because how they reacted, it was not random. It looked like most of the players know what's happening, knew the plan, and they were waiting for that. Some of the players of DTI died, indeed, and units, but most of them have moved away, waited for Eclarides' push to finish, and when Eclarides were moving back to their defensive position, they have pushed. Here, over here, you can see this, what's happening. The Eclarides losing a lot of units. This is the key thing. Eclarides pushed, but they used all their resources in one go, and they didn't have enough to defend and hold the counter push from DTI. So DTI moved in, and basically they cleared out all the defenders. After that, the fight have happened. A lot of dying happened. Over here you can see within span of 20 seconds, many units have not survived. DTI was pushed out thanks to few good movements, flanking maneuvers, and moving their archers as well. They cleared, the Eclarides cleared the archers from DTI, and they moved, replaced them with their own archers. They cleared out the courtyard, but unfortunately they didn't have enough units, and they didn't have the enough heroes to defend. Nevertheless, they tried. It actually looked very nicely for quite a long time here, and definitely Eclarides' team finished with a style, killing a lot of units, and as said in the beginning, this is their highlight game, the best they have performed, and it was very nice. To be honest, if DTI made one or two more mistakes, it could go into totally different direction. So congratulations to both team, DTI taking the third place, something definitely to be proud of.